how do you take your experiences as an athlete, incorporate in that into how you're coaching your athletes now?
Well, I think, you know, everybody needs a little bit something different. So like some people ultimately, you know, getting them to believe in themselves and feel ready, I think is important. Mm-hmm. And so, but everybody has different strengths and weaknesses. And I always, you know, like people say, you got to work on your weaknesses, but I think you just always have to play to your strengths at the end of the day.
Okay.
You're going to feel good, you know, like in those things, it's going to make you mentally feel better. And you have to work on those weaknesses, but you can't obsess on them either. And so, so I think taking a lot of the mistakes that I made is I was always trying to fix things. Maybe that, you know, like I would run out of fuel in the marathon, or I was like, oh, I didn't have enough speed. I'd try to go back and work on those instead of just being like, these are my strengths. I'm going to work on these. I'm going to take a little bit of time to spend on my weaknesses, just get better and better and better. I was always rushed. I was always like, let's come back. I'm missing this part. I'm missing that part. And so I needed to have more direction, I think, and focus. And I was just very difficult probably to coach in some ways because I thought that I knew better than the coaches that had been doing it for a while. And so I'm hoping that all these athletes, they know that I've made the mistakes before, you know, so I'm just going to try to help them avoid those mistakes, and their talent is already there. We've identified the people that we think are going to be great. So we already believe in them. We just need them to believe in themselves and to trust us to give them all the support they need. And so I hope that's what I hope to do with them.